Hello everyone and welcome back to ZooCrafting! I am Zookeeper Seri and we are standing here in front of our beautiful giraffes who are going to be moved to their new home today! I am so excited! We have worked very, very hard and we have got the giraffe barn done this week! I'm sort of in shock that it came together that quickly, but that's how it normally goes in the zoo when we really commit ourselves to something. But we are going to be gathering up some treats for the giraffes from our house today, some more of the materials and tools that we need to finish up their giraffe barn, and then we're going to take you guys! We're going to gather you guys up in our little safari nets and we are going to be moving our giraffes over to their giraffe barn all the way over in the safari zone. Look! You can see their little giraffe barn right here. That is so cool. And look at how nice and thick this area is with acacia trees now. That's wonderful. So they should be very, very happy over there. Agent Noodles! These are my little noodle doodles. I really should get your noodle shop done this summer. That would be so cool. But yes, we're going to finally move the giraffes out of my front yard so that they no longer have to sit in my front yard and put them over in their exhibit in the safari zone. And hi, guys! We're going to be breeding and naming them today. So I've got tons of name tags that we have piled up from the names you guys suggested in previous episodes inside of a chest in the giraffe barn, and we are going to be breeding them with apples today to start having a whole giraffe herd. I'm so excited! And it looks like golden yellow lupin. Thank you so much! So it looks like a little garden hedgehog, which is one of our ambient animals that now lives in our yard, has dropped another summer flower, and in this case it is the golden yellow lupin, which is very pretty. We have another one over here, so I think I'm going to put this one over here. Hello, one of my mini cloned boyfriend darlings. So yeah, I think we'll go ahead and we will put that other lupin over there. We've got some onions. I guess I should take the onions with me. I can't believe the onions are actually one of the things used as an enrichment item in real life zoos for giraffes. I did not see that coming. Onion. I mean, I could see grapes. I could see maybe, my little hedgehog is talking with the hedgehog's talking with the squicken. Ah, that's so cute. I wonder what kind of conversation those two would have. But yeah, I mean, I could see berries. I could see apples. I could see all sorts of other things being enrichment items for giraffes, but onions? I did not see onions coming. All right, it looks like we have some mail. So let's come over and let's check the mail really quickly. Hello, Jude. How are you doing today? Yep, we've got all those zombies I need to take out. And then from Ben. Essence berry bush. What? Oh my gosh. And then we've got a message from Pavo too. And Goldenrod and Lapis Lazuli. And question please. Hey, Seri, I hope you're doing well. Well, as you know what happened to my old house and I lost all my animals, I was wondering if I could possibly get another clone of Quill. I noticed that your squicken have once again multiplied, but I felt it was a bit rude to come and take one without asking. I also didn't quite realize how great a source of ink sacks he was until I had him no more. I don't know if you want anything in return. Something to help out with your giraffes, perhaps? Just let me know. See you soon. Pavo! Yay! Oh my gosh, we should do that like tomorrow. That would be really awesome. So we'll take over, I definitely have enough squicken. Ah, and he gave me goldenrods! We should decorate the goldenrods in the giraffe exhibit too. That would be so cool. Thank you, Pavo! Oh my goodness. And then Ben gave us some essence berry bushes. This is so cool. And then I have a whole bunch of zombies. I have a feeling those are from Ben. Or maybe, actually, I don't know who they're from because everybody knows how much I love curing up the villager zombies, but we'll go ahead and put these guys inside too. So yay, yeah, we can totally do that. Tomorrow we will go ahead and we will gather up our little collection of squicken, which indeed clone themselves on a regular basis. And I think we even have, all right, move your butt, Carlos, move your little feathered rump. Oh gosh, Carlos, why are there multiple of you? Oh my goodness. Carlos, why? Oh gosh. All right, hey, Pochi. But we can definitely come in here and we can gather up a whole bunch of the ink sacks and take them to Pavo as a gift. So we'll work on that in a little bit. Okay, let's get out of the chicken pen. There's so many cloned chicken. It's kind of ridiculous. Hello, Martha. Ah, thank you for the dodo egg. Okay, I'm going to put that away as well. Oh, it feels so good to be back home, back in the zoo, doing all the things we do here. All right, let's see. Some lapis lazuli. I need to tuck that somewhere. I need to take my zombies. I need to put them somewhere. Okay, so what are we going to do first? Let's take the essence berries upstairs where they belong, and we'll put this book from Pavo. You guys, look at all these memories. Oh, this is why we need to go and leave more mail at other people's houses, because all of this, these are like bookshelves full of notes and questions and just comments and kind little snippets from our friends. These we gotta go leave some mail at other people's houses this week. That's gonna have to be something we do tomorrow, because it's just so much fun to collect up the mail. And when we get the new zoo crafters in, oh my goodness. And yes, I know many of you are watching, you're like, Seri, I sent an email, and I am getting through. We had like 200 emails, so I'm working through them, you guys. I definitely am. And it's our little Chips who watches over our butterflies. I actually think this particular little Chips really loves watching over the butterfly collection we've gathered, so I think he'd probably stay. Look, we have like 3 red admirals. That's so cool. I think he'd stay when the other little Chips leave so that they can go to their chocolate chip making factory, which is something we're gonna have pretty soon. All right, let's gather all these up, and let's try out some of this and some of these. And can I reach the ones back there without getting pricked? Oh, I did. I managed to reach them without getting pricked. Wonderful. All right, reach some of those. And we should start harvesting our essence berries pretty regularly, because on Sundays, I kind of want to start going into the Village of Light and the Zomberry Village. And I want to spend some time in Zomberry Village, actually, on Sunday, taking care of our former zombie villagers who are now normal villagers, and curing up a few of the zombie villagers. I realize we don't have to do it like all at once, because there's so many zombie villagers. I won't have enough experience. Even with all of my wonderful experience berries, I won't have enough experience if I cure all of the zombie villagers we have in the basement at once. So I'm thinking on Sundays, we might go ahead and cure the zombie villagers and turn them into normal villagers. And so I'm probably going to need to start... Oops, I accidentally popped this out of its spot. Didn't mean to do that. Let's put the silver sword away. I need a new treasure room, don't I? Because this is sincerely turning into just the essence berry grove. But yeah, so Sundays might become zombie villager days. So let me know what you guys think about that. And then I would need lots of names for our zombie villagers, because we would be curing them. I want to leave this lapis lazuli up here because it's a gift. It's a wonderful gift from our friend. So we're going to leave this here too. Oh yeah, my ice bow. I almost forgot I had my ice bow here too. And then let's see, I'll leave this little note from Ben. It'll just go over here because that's a little friendship note too. And we'll take the zombie villagers downstairs. And then while we're down there, we can gather up some of the materials that we need for the giraffe barn. And then we'll head out. But yeah, so I'm thinking like one day during the weekend will be our normal Saturday special. And one day during the weekend will be our zombie like villager day. And our day we spend in the village, Zomberry Village, because I miss my boys. Junior, Ash Junior. Oh my goodness. Like JJ Junior the Junior. Oh my goodness. I miss visiting with them. So we'll spend some time with them on Sundays and curing up the villagers and all of that. And what the heck? Really? Really? Why is my basement full of this is flesh, isn't it? Yeah, this is flesh. Flesh, and it looks like bloodstone, and this is blood, isn't it? Let's see, I'm pretty sure that this is like a pool of blood. Is this you guys? Is this you guys? You bloodthirsty, flesh-eating creatures. Pigman Fern, are you okay back there? I'm really worried. Not only is it summer and you are still inside of like your normal outfit, but look at these guys. Look at these guys. They're bloodthirsty vampire penguins. And it appears that no, I'm going to get you guys a new home. We are not having my basement turn into flesh and blood and bloodstone like this. This is not acceptable. It looks like it's totally like just spreading everywhere. If I get too close, they're going, ouch. Oh my gosh, that really hurt. That really hurt. No, naughty, bad. You have like the flesh blocks you can eat off of. At least I know this is like a plant. This is like the flesh blocks are kind of like moss that grows everywhere. So technically it's like vegan, maybe vegan flesh. You guys eat that, not me. Rude. Oh my goodness. I'm going to angrily eat a cookie in your direction. Birthday presents from Ben always come with a little bit of prickly sides. This is oh, so gross. Oh, gross. Oh my goodness. Okay, so we'll have to clean that up. We'll have to clean that up and we'll have to move the... that leaf scared me. Bad leaf. Oh my gosh, that's funny. But yeah, we're going to have to clean that up and take care of that. And where are all my zombie villagers? I think I have so many... zombies and zombie villagers. I don't even know which pile is zombie and which pile is zombie villager anymore. But yeah, we'll grab like 2 or 3 of these guys every weekend cure them up, and I think this may be a zombie villager as well, maybe. And we'll cure them up and give them names that you guys can suggest and add them to Zomberry Village, because Zomberry Village is made almost entirely of villagers who used to be zombies that I have cured and tried to help out, because we really do try to bring them back to life and give them a second chance so that they don't have to spend all of eternity as a zombie, because that's just so sad if you ask me. And where the heck... Oh, there it is. I was like, no, I've lost my gold ore berries. And we do need those gold ore berries in order to make the golden apples that are needed to cure zombie villagers. And actually, somebody did donate to build a golden apple tree in the Zomberry Village. So we'll be working on that too. All right. So I think I need a little bit of iron. We'll take like 6 things of iron over to our giraffe barn, which is what we're still gathering materials for. Even if I have bloodthirsty vampire penguins and Pavo's request for a quill, a squicken. Quill is the name of the squicken that has cloned himself, which is why I say a quill, because we have multiple quills, but they're just squicken. So let's see. But we are trying to gather stuff up for the giraffe barn. So I know I need some iron. Oh, and I also need to make some new... Do I have any steel? I do need a new pair of shears, because my shears are just about to break. So let's go ahead and grab a new pair of shears, and steel shears actually last a lot longer than normal shears. And then let's see, do I have a lot of acacia wood over here? I actually do. So we're going to grab some of those as well. And then I think I need to get just some like normal wood. It looks like jungle wood is actually the thing I have the most of. That's interesting. So we'll gather up some jungle wood, and I want to take it because I want to build some scaffolding that you can climb up so that you can go ahead and feed the giraffes. A lot of you guys suggested building like a little thing you could climb and like feed the giraffes from. So we're definitely going to work on that. Do I have any ladders or anything in here? What about in here? No. Okay. Well, we'll just have to use the jungle wood for that. Do I need anything else? I need apples. I need lots and lots of apples to feed our giraffes as snacks. And feeding giraffes apples is actually what breeds them too. Agent Noodles, you know what's up. You know what's up. Aw, look at him. He's headed up to the bedroom. That's exactly where I was going to go, Agent Noodles. All right. Got to sleep on my side of the bed. There we go. And then we'll just settle in for the night. Ah, nice and safe. Hello, little chips. I'll write in my joy journal later. All right. And then we're going to... Oh, careful there, Agent Noodles. Oh, gosh. Where'd he go? Agent Noodles? Oh, okay. He's just admiring the beautiful view. And it is a gorgeous view. I really love the view from my bedroom. All right. And then let's go downstairs and we'll pick some fresh apples from the yard. But we'll also check and see if I have any apples in the pantry that we will gather up. And we will use as food for our giraffes. And then we can finally move the giraffes into the giraffe yard. And then we'll be able... There we go. Lots and lots of apples. And then we'll be able to give them their names. And there were so many name suggestions for our giraffes, you guys. It was absolutely amazing. I went through and added in just tons and tons until I ran out of name tags. And we will be using more names in the future. I guess I'll keep this onion. Are there more fresh onions? No, the girls have already harvested up those onions. But I guess I'll just keep the onion, because apparently onions are giraffe enrichment items. I'm going to have to look up more enrichment items, because that just sounds amazing. All right, let's come downstairs. Ah, my apple barrel. All right, apple barrel. You only have one stack? Oh my gosh. All right, well, do I have more apples in my fruit basket? I do. So there's one stack. There's 2 stacks of apples. So there's almost 3 stacks. Okay, we'll take these, but I guess we should make some apple trees then. I could have sworn we had more apples, but we'll make some apple trees to put over by the giraffe exhibit. I don't know if I want to put it in the giraffe exhibit, because if they eat the apples, they can make themselves sick from having too much enrichment, too much food. So I'll think about that. And then fresh veggies. I have tons of onions. So I guess I'll take a couple stacks of onions, and those can be like for the giraffes, I suppose. What can you do with onions? Let's see. You can put them in the food processor, but you can also make a chico roll, a random taco, spicy greens, meat pie, McPams, veggie stir fry. Oh, I need to make Zoo Kitchen comeback, don't I? Stuffed eggplant, lamb barley soup, guacamole, hash, marinated cucumber. That actually sounds delicious. Mushroom risotto. I love mushrooms. Fried rice that you could make with vulture eggs. Beans and rice, grilled skewer. That actually sounds really yummy. That sounds like something I could totally see happening. in our zoo, bell pepper. You know, we need to get the summer garden up and going too. What am I doing? It is officially summer. The summer solstice has already passed. So we need to get the summer garden up and going soon too. Oh gosh, there's so much to do. So much to do in the zoo. The mantra of my life. All right, and I think I'm going to pick these grapes so I have something yummy to snack on while we are working over in the giraffe exhibit. Are you guys ready for this? We're going to head out. I'm going to load you up in safari nets now, and you're going to get your new names, and then we're going to try to make a giraffe, maybe. So that's going to happen. All right, in you go, buddy. All right, there's one giraffe. Two giraffe. Three giraffe! Yay! And then let's move this little well as well. Haha, move the well as well. Because this would be a good thing to put over in their... Like, it's just a little brick well, but we could probably put this inside of their barn, at least. And then we can add in some other sorts of watering holes. So a couple of people asked for watering holes for the giraffes. And it's kind of funny, you guys, because giraffes actually need less water than a camel, we learned. Oh, and there's just a stray dodo egg on the ground. All right, well, let's eat this. And then I'll pick up that dodo egg, and then we'll head out. And then we're going to head off. Lily and Tate are actually waiting for us at the giraffe exhibit. So now we have a whole bunch of things we know we need to do. I need to take care of my zombie villagers on the weekend. There's another dodo egg over there. I know I need to... Oh, yeah, an apple tree. Darling, hug. I need to clear up all my boyfriends. Oh, there's too many boyfriends. I miss kissing my boyfriend. But when you don't know which one of the clones is your real boyfriend, it makes things awkward. All right, and then let's see. Where is... Let's grab... Maybe like 6 apple trees, I guess. That seems like a lot, but at the same time, it would kind of be cool. And I sort of want to put down some more flowers. Like, I think the goldenrod are a good place to start, but do we have anything else that would look pretty cool? Even just as decorative pieces over in the giraffe exhibit? I do want to put down some of that grass, the grass gardens that can spread. Yellow toad flax. Maybe some of the sun, like the columbines, these little columbine flowers might be good. Something like this guy. I think of this Inca gold, and chilia. I think that would be a good one to put down. And maybe some of these, like 3 harmony lilies. They don't have to be things that would particularly always represent a species that actually exists where the giraffes would be. They just need to be things that would be kind of cool. As a decorative piece. So, or this hawkweed, that's what I'm talking about. I think the hawkweed is really what I'm looking for. So we'll start with the goldenrod and the hawkweed, and we'll see if we want to add in maybe some dandelions would be good here and there. In fact, we'll take one dandelion just to see what it would look like. But yeah, remember guys, even if these are not species that we would actually see in real life where the giraffes would live, zoos often use species of plants, especially from all over the world, to build up a nice looking exhibit, because just the visual effects of an exhibit have a major impact on if people are going to come back to your zoo and help you fund the zoo. So there's that. The broom sneakweed actually might be another good one to take. Ah, here's a grass garden. Okay, I need to make a little room. Hang in there, little giraffes. Oh yeah, and I had all of these seeds I needed to put in here. They're gonna have to wait now. Okay, let's move this over here really quickly. Hang in there, little giraffes. I'll get you out in just a second. And then let's see, like that's a desert plant, so maybe it would be good for the shrubland. Let's grab this grass garden. I think that'll be good for now. And we'll start from here and we'll see what we end up with. All right, let's keep moving. And yes, for those of you guys who have been asking, Dog Quest will return. It will return soon. So don't worry, that will be happening. All of our puppies, we will be visiting with our puppies. Dog Quest is going to be coming back. It's just a matter of like so much to do in the zoo. So much to do in life, but I love being here, you guys. It's really amazing how this world has, when you show up more or less every day for years, it really becomes super special to you. Oh gosh, it's mountain apples. Do I really want to risk it? I'm going to try. All right, giraffes, I'm done risking it. That was about as far as I wanted to risk it. And there is our wonderful Zomberry Village. Look at the view from down here. And we will be going back up to Zomberry Village and working there in the weekend, like I said. I'm really looking forward to that. All right. And I'm so excited about the idea of all of the various... Oh, gosh. Okay. That was a bit of a jump. Don't jump while running down a slope. Noted. I'm so excited about all of the ideas for the other ambient animals that we can add into our zoo as well. That's going to be great. Keeper Mitchie, hey! All right, so let's go ahead and teleport ourselves over into the safari zone. Doink! There we go. Oh gosh, who was that? Somebody made a really cute noise. All right, come along, my little giraffes. This is it, you guys. We're finally adding the giraffes in. They are going to be in their new home. They're going to be stretching those long, long legs of theirs. Oh my gosh. Did I tell you guys that they have vertebrae that are 10 inches long? They have the same number of vertebrae that we do, but their vertebrae are like 10 inches and ours are not. Ours are teensy tiny. Lily Tate, the giraffes are going to be released. The giraffes are going to be released. I'm so excited. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Now the moment of truth. Did I make the giraffe barn tall enough? Just barely! Look at that! Oh my gosh, yes! Okay, roam free, my little ones. Watch your head in some, like, instances. Oh my goodness, I'm so happy right now. Hi, guys! You guys, they're free! They're free! The giraffes are free! They have room to roam! They are here! Oh my goodness! And we're gonna have so many giraffe babies. We're gonna have so many giraffe babies. And then once we get like a lot of giraffes here in this exhibit, that's when, after we complete the exhibit that's out here, we will... Oops, sorry about that. Okay, Lily, I guess the giraffes can't get out of that. But that's when we will close off this area because we just have like one more big wall to build that will close off this entire area. And we will actually unleash the giraffes into this zone as well to have a gigantic mixed species exhibit that we're going to have a little Jeep tour going through. So that's the big goal with over here. Because if you look carefully, it's kind of hard to see from the map, but this entire area is closed off all the way along here, and then I just need to finish this zone of it up, and then this whole area is going to be kind of a Jeep tour safari zone that you can go into. So it's going to be really awesome. I'm so excited. All right, watch out, little girl, watch out. All right, so let's name these giraffes. Ah, they're walking around, they're so cute. Let's name these giraffes. We have one boy, two girls, because I said so, not because there's any indicators, to be honest. But we have one male and two females. So we're going to go ahead and give them some names, and then we're going to feed the male and one of the females an apple to go ahead and breed them. I hope that works. I've never tried breeding them before. So here is a giant chest of names. These are only some of the many amazing names you guys suggested. And I know I want to name one of the males. I want to name the male. Let's see. Queen, Dottie, Ellen, Nigel. I want to name the male Nigel. And the reason I want to name the first male Nigel is after Nigel Thornberry from the Wild Thornberries, which I absolutely adored growing up. It was the best. It is still one of the best. Rewatching it now as an adult is amazing because there was so much humor that went over my head when I was a kid. It's awesome. I love it. But there's tons and tons and tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of names in here that you guys have suggested. And I plan on adding in many, many more. This was just until I ran out of name tags. Savannah sounds like a perfect name for one of our founding females. And we're going to have so many baby giraffes. So if your name hasn't been picked yet, or if like we don't pick your name just now, don't panic. It will happen. And now I need, you know, Karalia. I think Kopi, Tafari, Kreen. I kind of like Kreen. Creenie, because it reminds me of Kreen from our Horse Haven series. So we're going to go with Nigel, Savannah, and Creenie for now. And those will be our three giraffes. So Nigel, there you go, buddy. Oh my gosh, you have a name now. This is so cool. And then this is going to be Savannah. There we go. And then this is going to be Creenie. There we go. And then let's go ahead and feed an apple to Nigel and to Savannah. And then we're going to stand back. And there's a baby giraffe. And there is a baby giraffe. Oh my gosh, Tate. Oh my gosh. Just like that. I don't know if they have a cool down period. I'm going to say that's Sapphire, because that sounds like a perfect name. It's a little girl. It's Sapphire. And we have a baby giraffe. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy right now. This is where it starts, you guys. This is where it starts. And now they have to cool down for a little while. Look at them moving a little giraffe family herd. Ah, this is the best ever. And they have to cool down. So we're going to spend tomorrow actually visiting. In fact, I'll have to drop everything like into the various chests, all of the materials we have been dutifully collecting to try to take care of our giraffes. I'll drop these into the various chests. And then tomorrow we are actually going to spend quite a bit of time gathering up the quills and going over. I don't know if I really literally have everything. I dream of like this gigantic care package for Pavo because he lost so much. So we'll gather up a whole bunch of stuff. It won't be enough because I know I've been putting it off because I want it to be perfect, and it won't be, but I'm going to do my best. And we'll take him some quills, and then we might leave some mail with other people, and then we'll come back and we will work a little bit more because we're almost done, you guys. I want to build some like viewing platforms. We need to get the big giant termite mound set up so that we can collect little termite mounds from it. I want to add in some oxpeckers and some other types of ambient animals to share this area. And I mean, I guess I need to add a keeper and things like that in here and some more like educational kiosks. But we're doing great, you guys. We're doing really great. I'm so happy. All right, baby giraffes. Huzzah. All right, I'll see you guys in the morning. Bye-bye.